Solar energy. When you think about solar energy, what do you think about? No, really. We always talk about renewables. We always talk about solar energy. But when you hear the words solar, what comes to mind? Think about it. I'm willing to bet it goes a little something like this. You think about panels, solar panels that you install on your roof. You think about expenses. You think they're awfully costly. You have to buy a solar panel. You have to renovate the roof of your home. And then you have to keep up with the cost of maintenance, installation, and upkeep. Oftentimes, when you think of solar panels, you think they're remarkably expensive. And to be honest, you're right. The US found that a single solar panel system to be installed on your roof costs approximately, on average, $15,000. Now, if you're like me, you don't often have $15,000 to shell out on solar energy. And that makes sense. That's why 80% of Americans cannot afford and cannot access rooftop solar panels. Put simply, they're unaffordable and inaccessible. But that's the problem. So far, solar energy has missed out on their biggest demographic. Us, you and me, common people who can't afford to shell out $15,000 when we want to get involved in renewable energy. But solar panels on your roof are the past. They aren't, in fact, the future. In fact, the future of solar energy is beyond our rooftops, and it's called community solar. To understand community solar, we need to go back to the very beginning. What exactly does energy look like right now? Well, you use a certain amount of energy every day, every month, and every year. Then you pay your local utility provider to continue providing your energy and cover the cost of the energy that you've used. But what if I told you that instead of paying your local utility provider, you could instead pay a renewable energy company? That's what community solar is. Instead of paying CPS Energy in San Antonio, you have the ability, and across the world, to pay a renewable energy company instead. But what exactly are these renewable energy companies doing? They're effectively solar farms. They're generating solar energy at no cost to you itself. They're automatically doing this. They have a mass number of solar panels and are automatically generating large amounts of solar energy. So what do? You can contract with these companies and get them to cover a certain percent of your energy for a certain period of time. Effectively, you are renting out their solar panels to cover your own energy needs. It's the red box of solar energy. You are simply taking their solar panels and using them, but you never have to see them. See, think about it like this. Let's say I use 10,000 kilowatt hours of energy every year. I'm able to go up to a solar energy company, like South Texas Solar, for instance, and say, hey, I want you to cover 20% of my energy for the next 10 years. What happens is this. I do the equivalent of rent out solar panels to cover 20% of my energy use. Then, whenever I get my energy bill from CPS Energy or my local utility provider, I only actually pay for 80% of my energy. Why? Because 20% of it is created by renewable energy, and that acts as a rebate towards my utility bill. Effectively, it's a solar energy subsidy. But mechanistically, how does it work? Effectively, what you're doing is simple. Whenever you contract with a renewable energy company, you are getting the renewable energy company to feed solar energy, in this case, directly to the power grid. So the more people that use community solar, the more of our energy grid that is powered by solar energy. You're not changing the energy itself, you are changing where the energy comes from, which means the more widespread it becomes, the more you change our energy at its source. But you're probably thinking, is this 2050? Is it 2060? When will we actually be able to realize its benefits? I'm here to tell you, it's right now. In fact, the United States already has 1,600 fully functional and fully operational community solar installations right now. And just 1 week ago, The White House actually signed a $2.5 billion deal with the two biggest community solar operations in the country. The purpose? To provide community solar to light up the homes of 140,000 Americans. Community solar is not our future. It's our present. But what does this actually mean for you and me? What can we take away from this in our daily lives? It's action. This allows us to invest in solar energy right now. Not in 2050, not in 2060, today. When you go home, and if you take anything from this talk, let it be action. Why? Well, first off, you increase accessibility to solar energy. Why? Well, first off, because solar energy is no longer zero sum. For too long, solar energy has been a zero sum game. You either can buy a solar panel or you can't. You either can shell out $15,000 or you can't. This changes the question. With community solar, it's not a question of can. The question is how much. It is a question of scale. If you're able to cover 2% of your energy, so be it. You can cover 5% or 50%, 10% or 100%, all with community solar. So if you don't have $15,000 like me, that's fine. You don't need to. Whether you have $1,000 or $10,000, the cost no longer precludes you from accessing solar energy. Cost, irrespective of your socioeconomic status, is no longer an actual factor, prohibiting you from accessing the renewable energy industry. But second, what actually happens to how solar energy and energy in general costs? It actually goes down. Solar energy and energy across the board becomes that much more affordable. Why? Because the government is perfectly aware of the benefits of solar energy. So much so that with the Inflation Reduction Act last year, there are a host of tax credits and tax benefits ranging from 10% to 30%. And this has been empirically proven. So much so that for people's utility bills, empirical studies have shown that your utility bill can decrease by 5 to 15%. That sounds like a good reason to invest in solar energy right now, for the sole reason of decreasing the barrier to accessing both renewable energy and the affordability of this technology. But let's think on a bigger scale. What happens to the energy movement as a whole? What happens to our climate? You actually make a more sustainable climate movement. And that's because most of progress throughout society, throughout history, has not come from the top down. It is never started by the national or federal government. It starts from the ground up. It starts on a local and state level with communities from the start. And that's because community solar and these industries are primarily grassroots. They're local companies that are investing in solar energy. So strengthening our communities are an investment into our future. For too long, solar energy has been exclusive. It has been exclusive and it's been expensive. Community solar gives us accessibility and affordability at near no cost right now. So from Pittsburgh to Paris and LA to London, community solar will light our path forward. Thank you.